Set the poplar in the hall. Is that time for another? What's gone the Lord tempting? Yeah, the vicar stands a-praying.
lounging slowly out the sea. Thank you.
and storm of eyes trying to fake the storm. White sea snaps at the heels across the fields as the white sea snaps at the heels of a soft prayer whisper.
but his reindeer jack. In Spanish fingers he great races still wine wonders. He's piling up the doorstep to the wine club. Thank you. still remember the smell of the concrete. As the days on to none, there was moving agony. He goes down to the bar and warms his feet. Oh, I feel alone beyond half the road. Starvation and alone. And one of my friends, don't just run away anything. Your quarrels obviously don't.
Thank you, Tom.
About the end of last week, I had a telephone call from a very famous English television producer who called me up and said, could we please, although we were leaving 2 days later, come up with this theme music for a new BBC Arts programme. So, being rather keen on the arts, we did our best to comply with his wishes. And here's David Gerald Palmer at the keyboard to tell you what we do.
In England. There were a lot of queens. In fact, there are still quite a few. And this king that I will tell you about is called Henry VIII. And he was quite infamous. And other than chopping off the heads of his six wives, he pulled down all of the best buildings in England. And as a bricklayer, I find that to be rather unnerving. Actually, Arthur's Peach, probably back as a bricklayer. However, Henry VIII's claimed fame really lay in his work as a composer. He wrote, of course, that famous English ditty, Greenfleet, which, of course, is a very sunny title for a pond. And he wrote a second hit. And if you can imagine Henry VIII having a rock and roll band, it would have sounded like this.
Thank you.
cross lay standing ground. Last of the line, I took an honest day's time. Standing there beside the gun. Ripped to the landlord, chasing the fight. Lines of the nostrils, after. Summon the kind, feel the pressure on the mind. With a shy, honest face. I taught me a word behind the power, slipping and sliding free.
very much. In case anyone's falling asleep at the back, we'll play you a nice, gentle little song, which is no lullaby.
That's all. Martin?
Thank you.
from John Evans on the keyboard. And of course, Gladys Lewis as usual, a lovely little fishnet number, Mr. Barrymore Barlow on the drums. Now that some of you probably noticed, we have yet again another bass player following the demise of poor John Glasscock. This time, and it's his very first concert with Jethro Tull. And Dave Pegg's name is Dave Pegg on the bass. He wrote this next song, and he's going to tell you a little bit about it.
Right, here we go then. Well, this is a little instrumental which, in fact, Martin and myself threw together rather rapidly last week. And it's dedicated to a guy called Flann O'Brien, who's like an Irish writer who's now brown bread. But the tune's called Jams O'Donnell's Dick. Hope you enjoy it. Thanks for your patience. Thank you. Saw you riding yourselves over the fields, and you make all your animal deals, and your wives that don't know how it feels.
Secret streets, rings like flowers of flame. The last wave of comments, the new back away. But you need to do more to the heels. And your suntan is rapidly heals. And your wise men don't know how it feels. So far away.
Yeah. Thank you.